Next thing you want to do is pull the spark plug out of it. So just going to pull the wire off, put it, push it aside, put a socket wrench on it, nice and easy, spin it out, and have a look. It's quite clean. It's got some blackness to it, but there's no large deposits. Looking at the insulator around the electrode in the center, that's not cracked. That's very important. Inspect the insulator. Here's the insulator on the outside. That's the electrode. The spark plug is a little bit blackened, a little bit fouled, you would say. Now, the most likely cause of this is overfueling, a rich fuel condition. Reasons for a blackened or carbon-deposited spark plug would include things like too rich a fuel mixture, or a sticking choke, or a clogged air cleaner, you know, anything that's going to increase the fuel in the fuel-air ratio. Also, a good possibility is oil seeping past the rings on the compression piston and getting up into the combustion chamber and fouling it. Yeah, I had the good sense to hold on to the literature that came with the lawnmower when I bought it 10 years ago. It says right here, the gap on the spark plug should be 30 thou, so we'll just check that with our feeler gauges. It's pretty much a perfect fit for 30 thou, so there's nothing wrong with our gap. Clean it up with a nice soft wire brush and reuse it. Anyway, so there is no adjustments here. The only adjustment I can make is I can bend this metal tang right here that the governor spring is controlled by, and that will speed up my high end. This is the governor spring right here, and this metal tang here is its anchor point. Stretch the spring further to speed it up, or compress the spring a tiny bit to slow it down. In this case, I'm burning a little too rich, so I'm going to add a tiny bit of speed to the top end. There we go. I'll just bend it a tiny, tiny bit. Here we go. I'm just going to put in my spark plug after giving it a quick check. You definitely may want to change your spark plugs. They're cheap, and sometimes if you have a no start, no run problem, it could be as simple as a dead plug. And it's such a common problem that if you still have a no start, no run problem, it's not a bad idea to go get a second new plug and make sure that the brand new plug you just tried isn't also dead. Okay, now I've run the machine for an hour after the tune-up, and check it out, it's starting to whiten. Okay, it's obviously hotter over on this side, you can see that. Spark is hotter on that side, but it's starting to whiten up, which means something's worked. Either the tune-up or the raising of the operating speed has leaned out the mixture enough that we're starting to get a nice clean burn.